each and every story that matters to the nation. So these terrorists, these so-called terrorists are getting intimidated. They are political leaders and political masters within Kashmir and out of Kashmir are getting intimidated. This is a threat to the media fraternity of India. Why Goa Chronicle was only picked? Why people who are associated with IT are only picked? Because you expose, we do debates every day on how Pakistan is trying to destabilize us, how China is trying to destabilize us. Why only workers of BJP are killed? Why only sarpanches of Apni Party are killed? Nobody touches the NC person. Nobody touches the PDP person. Because yesterday, Mehbooba Ji was talking about Afghanistan. She was supporting Taliban. So the people who expose them, the people who bring them the stories, the grassroots stories from to the India and to the whole world, the people who explain and explore that it is no freedom struggle. It's a jihad. It's a funded jihad. It's a funded propaganda by Pakistan. These people, those people are chosen and attacked. Those, the people who want to come in India, the people who want normalcy to get back to Kashmir, the people who want to get rid of bloodshed and want to come to the mainstream, people who do not, you know, who do not oppose 370 and 35A, these people are picked and attacked one by one. They are trying to frighten us. They are trying to intimidate us. They are trying to send a message. This was a targeted attack. Let it be a hand grenade. Let it be IED. That doesn't matter. Why only Goa Chronicle, the, you know, journalist? Why only him? What is his galti? Kya uski galti? He's reporting from the ground. What is happening? He's busting the propaganda of ISI. We are busting the propaganda of, you know, GHQ, Rawalpindi and all those media outlets, paid media outlets, those paid propagandists who work in US. When you do such things, you become target. You are targeted. They want to send a message to the whole country and to everybody. Look, this is what we do to the people who will speak the truth. This is what we will do to the people who want to bring normalcy to Kashmir. This is what we speak to the people who talk of a common Kashmiri on the ground, who wants peace and prosperity. These people are targeted. Uday, why not PDP workers? Why not NC workers? Why only we hear a BJP serpent shot? 2 days back, his family was eliminated. BJP worker shot, journalist shot. Why only this? There are other journalists also who, you know, do a kind of batting for them. Why they are safe in Kashmir? This is the answer we need to tell. This is what the nation needs to understand. We are being targeted. People who have nationalistic credentials, who bring the real stories to the nation and the world, they are being targeted for truth, for speaking for Kashmiris, for speaking for the nation. This is the unfortunate part. And this is the assault on whole media. I urge all the media houses, do not think it's Goa Chronicle, it's ITV network. This is the assault on the media. We all should get together and fight it and expose them to the world and ask questions to people like BBC, why they don't cover this? Ask questions to other Washington Post, why they don't cover this? Why a common local person, his family is being intimidated? Why you are hellbent to kill him and his family? Galti kya uski? He is doing his job, that is your problem. That is your problem, he's talking the truth, he's speaking the truth, he's presenting the voice of Kashmir and Kashmiri, that is your problem. That is the story of the day, Uday. And hats off to that gentleman, to his courage, for speaking the truth. And let them know, we are all with them, we are with you. The whole country is with you. Don't think you can intimidate us, don't think you can hide the truth. Uday.
Okay, Sumit, stay with us, let me...
Because at the end of the day, the people get the news what they are told. So somebody has to go, somebody has to dare to speak the truth, because there are a lot of paid lobbies, there are a lot of paid media houses who do the propaganda for ISI because there's a lot of money in the game. The point problem here is yesterday there was a talk that, I don't know how far it is correct, that under UAPA, both the factions of Hurriyat will be banned. If both the factions of Hurriyat are banned under UAPA, then a lot of people, a lot of disruption will happen. You see, after the exposures happened, the money coming from Pakistan stopped. ED raids the, these Hurriyat leaders, how much of money has been got? How many of leaders are under jail? And after that, the miracle is no patharbazi happens. Nobody is pelting stones. The terrorism incidents are going down. Tourism is going up. The apple exports, saffron exports are going up. Peace and overall things are getting back to the valley. So a lot of people who have worked, including Pakistan, ISI for 30 years, and there's a lot of people in the valley who have made fortunes out of this terrorism. They were in the business of terrorism, I can say. When their things are getting, you know, squeezed day by day, and when the locals, like this gentleman, whose home was attacked, the point to be what ma'am rightly makes is, he goes back to his home after 8 months. So they must have been watching this, they must have been waiting and watching his home for 8 months. So how is it? It cannot be a coincidence that I reach my home after 8 months and same day somebody comes and attacks my home. Because that talks about the nationalistic credentials. That is how much this person's expose and work is irking these people who are getting infected. Because when the nation knows what are they up to, when nation knows about their mansions, when nation knows about the multi-billion dollar Oshi scam, when nation knows about those, you know, all-weather swimming pools, when nation knows 100 crore rupees spent for the renovation of government bungalows, 100 crores for renovation. When these things come up, then they really know it is not about unemployment. It is not about youth are being alienated. It is when nation knows that 10,000 people line up for army recruitment. Then when nation knows people are lining up for government jobs, people are, when four elections happen, when DDC elections go successfully, these things are irking a lot of people. And who's reporting it? It's a local from the ground. It's a local journalist who is risking possibly his life to speak the truth. So they want to silence these messages. They want to silence their voices, and they want to intimidate the whole Indian media. They want to scare the Indian media, Republic of India, with the gun. But that's not going to happen, Uday. That's not going to happen. The Pakistan, China, ISI and their propagandas are not going to work. We'll not let them succeed. They have done it for a lot of years. It is not going to happen now. Even Pakistan media denied surgical strikes. Even they denied Balakot. But I always ask them a question, where is Masood Azhar? Nobody has an answer to that. So this hypocrisy, and if they think by silencing or attacking a few people, they can silence the Republic of India, well, that is a distant dream. That is never going to happen. There are a lot of patriots out there. If some, by God forbid, if somebody goes out, the other people will take his role. They cannot silence 1.3 billion people. And I appreciate the courage of Goa Chronicle, who are saying clearly, we are not intimidated, neither we are scared. Try what you can. And I urge the government of the day to give adequate protection to the gentleman and his family, because we have seen these killings happen. These are, Uday, very targeted killings for a section of politicians, for a section of media, for a section of patriots. They are not random acts of violence. It's not a hand grenade goes up and five people die. They are targeted attacks. These are targeted attacks. And this is what is the, you know, area of concern. And we need to talk about it. We need to let the nation know why these people are attacked. Inki galti kya? Because they speak the truth. That is their mistake. They want the, you know, peace and tranquility to come back. They want the Kashmiris to come back in the mainstream. That is their problem. That is their misery. They are doing national service. That is why they are being targeted. And these terrorists think they can get away with it. I urge the security forces, whoever has done it, should be handled appropriately and in minimum possible amount of time. Because by doing this, we will send a message to the real owners of these terrorists, who is ISI and who is Pakistan and who is people like Bajwa, Qureshi and Niazi. Let them know we mean business. They cannot intimidate us, and there these terrorists cannot intimidate us. We are a much powerful nation. Let's launch an operation all out and eliminate them as soon as possible and send a message. That will be my only message. We are with you, and anybody who is doing the nationalist job in Kashmir, we are with you. The whole nation is with you, and we will plead your cause till the end of our lives. Don't try to intimidate us. We are not scared. Get it straight in your head.
Okay, Sumit, stay with us. We have Kavinder Gupta, former Deputy CM of Jammu Kashmir, joining us on the broadcast at this point. Kavinder Gupta, what is your first reaction, sir, to this incident that has taken place in Baramulla, Jammu Kashmir? A reporter of Goa Chronicle attacked, his house attacked, his car damaged.